गुड
गुड
मॉर्निंग
मॉर्निंग
सर।
सर। गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। गुड
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग। गुड मॉर्निंग। Okay, we'll start in a couple of minutes.
Sir, which copy do we have to use?
Okay, so in our previous class we have started a discussion on what is the scope and what is the things that we will be covering in the syllabus this year. We also started some basics about the chapter cell, the unit of life. In the previous class we discussed what is a cell, what are the features of the cell, and why we consider cell as a unit of life. Okay, what you are telling, we are telling it is a unit, a fundamental unit of life is a cell. So when we look at the different organisms that are existing on the earth, okay, they may be very massive like a blue whale, okay, or they may be very tiny microorganisms. Whatever this diversity is there, they are all plants, animals, everything, they are all made up of cells. So what is a cell, how it was discovered, what is a cell theory and its importance, how does the cell vary in their number, size, shape and efficiency? All these things we will be looking. So this is a kind of a repetition of the previous class where we told that a cell is the fundamental structural, functional and biological unit of all known organisms. It is known as the building block of life and it is derived from the Latin name that is the cella, which means a small room. Okay. The term cell was coined by Robert Hooke. Okay. So Robert Hooke was a scientist and using a microscope, he was looking at these bark of the trees which are known as cork. So in some of the beverages, the bottles, they are closed using this cork. The cork is obtained from the bark of the tree. If you take a small section of this and look under the microscope, what Robert Hooke observed was these kind of small rooms or chambers, you know, small chambers are there. So because they look like these small rooms, he in Latin named it as a cell or cella. Okay. And mostly these cells, they are very much microscopic. They cannot be seen with the naked eye. If we want to look at the cells, if we want to study the cells, then we need a microscope. Okay. So there are the three types of microscope that are being discussed and are part of your syllabus. One is the simple microscope, compound microscope, and electron microscope. Simple microscope. Okay, the term is simple microscope. Simple means it is definitely very simple. It has only one lens. Okay. A simple microscope has only one lens. And what is the nature of this lens? Lenses are of different types, na? So for example, in the spectacles, we wear the lenses, right? Lens is there even in the specs. So, can you name type of lens, two, three types of lens, can you say?
Biconvex
lens. Convex lens. So, convex lens, concave lens. Yes.
So, it may be a convex or it may be concave.
So, convex.
Concave. So this is concave. The first one is convex. Right. Rather, because there are the two surfaces here, we will say bi. Okay, biconvex lens. Here also biconcave lens. Okay. So for example, when you use a magnifying lens, okay, this is a magnifying lens. Okay, detective types, magnifying lens. It is a single lens and the lens is a biconvex lens. If you use the biconvex lens, you will be able to zoom, okay, and you will be able to enlarge what you are trying to observe. So can we call such a simple lens a simple microscope?
Yes. No, sir.
What is a microscope? So first we should know what is a microscope. Microscope means micro means small in the micrometer scale. Scope means to see in the micrometer range. So using this magnifying lens, can we look at microorganisms?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Have you ever seen?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
No, sir.
No, sir.
You see, this handheld lens, this handheld magnifying lens cannot be considered as a typical microscope. Okay. But some authors may say that it can be considered as a simple microscope. So if you are able to look at the microscopic level, then it can be called as a microscope. If you are not able, simple, it is a lens with a very low performance, you are not able to see at a microscopic level, it is not a microscope. Okay. Now, the advancement was done by Anton von Leeuwenhoek. Okay, the scientist, he invented the microscope. So what we are seeing here, the typical structure of this microscope that was discovered in this 1672. The lens is here. Okay, you are all able to see where this hand is. Okay, the lens is here and it is a very tiny lens. Same, what is the type of lens? It is the biconvex lens. Okay, same, the lens is that only, whether you are using a magnifying glass or the lens that was used by the first discovery of the microscope by Leeuwenhoek. Same, biconvex lens. It's so small. Okay, and this whole structure is a metal plate. Okay, and here there is a needle like structure. On that one, very small amount of sample that you want to observe, for example, some pond water, dirty water, just a little bit you will add. This screw, the long screw that you were seeing, is used for focus, okay, adjustment of focus. And how it will be observed, you have to see against the light, like this. Okay, how many lenses are there in this microscope?
Only one
lens is there. Okay, this magnifying lens, much before Leeuwenhoek discovered the simple microscope, this magnifying lens is there, people have been using it, no problem. But using these kind of lenses, they were not able to look at the microorganisms. Leeuwenhoek, he made this kind of a simple design, okay, a simple screw system, just that is for adjusting the focus. You know, the people who are interested in photography, some of the kids, they are interested in photography. So it is not sufficient if you just zoom in, zoom out, no? You also need to adjust the focus, okay, otherwise the picture will be blur. Okay, you need to adjust the focus. So how you will adjust the focus? Using these kind of screws. Okay, so using this kind of device, Leeuwenhoek was able to magnify at 200 times. 200 times magnification he was able to achieve, and he observed many things, blood sample, water, you know, so many things. And he made detailed diagrams of those in his observation notebook. And for the first time, people were able to realize that there are microorganisms which we cannot see with our naked eye. That was a very beautiful discovery because he invented the simple microscope. Okay. Next, there were further enhancements, design modifications, you know, because with the Leeuwenhoek microscope, we have to see like this against the light, sunlight or something. Okay. And suppose some person likes to work in the night time, that is not possible. Evening time, difficult. Okay. So you need an artificial source of light. Okay. Artificial source of light. So similar, lot of other designs of microscopes started coming, in which there was a still single lens. Okay, here what you were seeing on the top is only one lens, and down there was a mirror. The purpose of the mirror was to collect the light and focus that light on the sample. Okay. Because if you give it a sufficient light, then only you can see more details. If it is so dark, then you cannot see so many details. Okay. For example, if you are going into a movie theater or something like that, okay, inside it's a bit dark. You cannot observe so many details of any person who is there in the room. Okay. If there is a sufficient lighting, then only we can observe the details. In a similar way, in this microscope also, after Leeuwenhoek, special arrangement was done for illuminating the sample, to light up the sample. The question is, what kind of mirror is it? This is a mirror. It is not a lens, it is a mirror. This is a lens. Which type of mirror will be better for collecting the light? Should that mirror be...
Sir, concave mirror.
Obviously, you want the mirror to be like this, so that when the light is hitting on this, it should go like this, you know, towards the center, and it should make it bright here. But if it is, this is the concave mirror. This is a convex mirror. In the convex mirror, the light will come, it will go outwards. Okay, hit and go outwards. It is useful in other purposes. So here the mirror is concave mirror. The lens is convex or biconvex lens. Okay. So far, any doubts you have? Anything you want to ask?
Yes. So in this, as you said that we have to put lens against lights, but sir, in the case of this bone and long simple binocular microscope, sir, in this case, sir, where light is formed, sir?
Yes. Here you can use either the sunlight or whatever the artificial light is there in the room in the form of tube light, or if there is a lamp, the lamp may be used. Okay, this kind of different apparatus can be used. Okay, ultimately what we need is a visible light. That's all. That is only is required. Source of the light should be anything that is giving the visible light.
Sir, suppose if at that place if we will put torch, sir, then it will work.
As I told, it should be the visible light. So the torch is also giving visible light, no?
And so one more question, sir. So in the Leeuwenhoek microscope, sir, there is a focus through which we can observe microscopic organism. Sir, suppose if in magnifying glass, if we put that focus, then through magnifying glass, can we see microscopic organism?
You see, the invention of the simple microscope by Leeuwenhoek is amazing because he was able to make such a high quality lens. In 1672, there were not many people in this world who could make a high quality lens. Leeuwenhoek family had a background of lens makers. Okay. With his that kind of ingenuity, he was able to make, you know, it is, what is a lens? A lens is nothing but glass, no? Glass. A glass that has to be made so perfect, inside there should not be any air bubble, there should not be any other impurities, it has to be very much transparent to light, okay, and it should have a very smooth curvature, okay, polishing should be such a that very smooth curvature. All these kind of things, okay, is the workmanship, how excellent you are in your work, okay. Such a kind of thing Leeuwenhoek was able to make very small and very excellent lens. That is why he was able to discover so many microorganisms and use this kind of thing. Okay. So.
Sir.
Yes.
So it means magnifying glass having some impurity.